Morning, boys and girls. I am back at Laurel Hill. Seems to be an endless journey, but everywhere is blown out. Again, Laurel Hill is really the only fishable water, and it is even high. Never fished it this high. It said 2.4 on the Ursina gauge. So we're gonna mess around. I got a beautiful day. Nothing really to work on instead of this leader system. Just dialing things in. So I got a couple new patterns that I am super excited about. One new pattern I'm super excited about. I don't even have a name for it yet, so I'll unveil that later when the sun comes up. It's about 55 now by 10 o'clock, which is a little over an hour from now. It should be close to 70, so with that real hard increase in temperature, water levels being up, it is, from what I can see from here, anyway, it's not muddy, but it is milky. So that's good. Last time I was up here when water levels were this high, it was a fishing bonanza. So hopefully today we'll get some numbers. That'd be fun. Still recovering from last week. And I fished hard. Had some good days. I'm running out of time. This is middle of March or middle of May. And kids only have a week or so of school. As soon as school's out, and time's gonna be spent by the pool. So this is gonna be one of the last outings I'm gonna have for a while. I still have my Davis trip and a trip to State College coming. So we're gonna try to make the most of our time here today. I'm gonna work my way up to the big corner and get my feet wet in here, just see if I can see what the flow is and catch some fish. So I adjusted my camera. I realized the last two videos I was pointing down a lot. Well, at least the angle was. I was bent over. I was really leaning out over like this, so it's blocking this whole field of vision, and that's kind of what you want to see. So we're gonna get our feet wet here and catch some fish, hopefully. Now, I've never fished this when it's been this high. It's really not high, but I know just being out over here for the last couple months pretty regularly, just a slight increase or decrease in that gauge. What I was seeing mostly was decreases, from when it's saying 2.0 to 1.8. That was a dramatic difference. So when I went from 1.8 to 1.6, and then went 1.6 to 1.4, you know, it was just the stream changed remarkably. So now that I'm going the other direction, this stream is gonna get really low here once the weather starts getting hot and the rain starts calming down. So this might be the last chance, yeah, till fall or winter that I see this kind of level in this creek. So hopefully you see the sunlight over here. Freaking bugs everywhere. I'm going to officially log a complaint if the new ecstasy material that I use on my eggs doesn't work as well as the old ecstasy material. So I was wondering that. I was tying it up, tying a bunch up for my Davis trip, and noticed that, hey, wait, this feels different, looks different to what I started putting in my box, but we'll see. I'm gonna start with this, and then we're gonna unveil a new pattern here. There you go. So just to give you some perspective there, at 2.2 feet, okay, that rock that this fly was stuck on, I normally stand in front of that. I normally stand there to fish that, and I'm standing in knee-deep water here. So if you're coming up to Laurel Hill, just keep that in mind. Really hoping for some caddis action today. I want to wait till it gets warmer. And I want to get away from that big tree behind me. Ooh, water's cold. That is really moving. Maybe it'll just be hanging out in the cushions today. Got that one to slow down. Wiggle my way out here. There's a shelf that I think I am standing on the edge of. It is. It's like you have to learn the pocket all over again. Yeah, this is definitely different fishing. It's too bad you can't see the fish. Yeah, that water is cold. It got down almost to 30 degrees last night. Pretty little bow. Oh look, that's a native. It has its tail, or what they're calling that adipose tail. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, that's cold.
Pull that thermometer out.
Ooh, that pocket looks nice up there now.
That's so much bigger.
Might be able to get something out of that.
I'm not gonna spend too much time here. I'm gonna do some research on some of these infrared thermometers.
Because I'm curious, if you're just shining the infrared at the water, how can it give you the temperature at depth? I don't know that it's possible it can do that, or whether that even matters. But I'll try to find out. I have my thermometer at my feet here, so just giving this a minute. It's like a 52. Yeah, it must have been a lot warmer lately. I was seeing some of the readings at night, you know, just keeping track of where I'm gonna fish the next day. And yeah, I mean, I was seeing temperatures in the high 60s last week or two, and I was like, come on, how can that happen?
Beginning of May. But
guess it can. I think I'm brave enough. Step over here. Should get my
staff out. But yeah, why would I?
It makes sense, right?
Okay, this is gonna give us a little bit longer.
Man, when you can get sunlight on that amnesia.
It looks so. Every time I catch a seam like that in fast water,
and that bait is just
standing there, not moving at all. Just still have a hard time comprehending that that's what we're doing here. I'm gonna lose this f***ing fish because of this net. I'm just letting them hang out. I can get a hold of this. You know what? Let's get him in. I can't get him in. It's too big.
Oh, he didn't like that either. He's seen that. Oh shit, that was close.
Damn it.
That's a nice fish, huh? What about that?
Alright, come on, chill, dude.
Move. Awesome. Hopefully you can see him.
I can't get him, he's too big.
Oh wow.
Look at the gold spots on him.
He is, let's see, 19 and 13. About 18.
Beauty. TM4, yeah.
Beauty. Go for it, brother.
Good start, guys. Okay. Who wants more? Me! Really got lucky there.
I don't know if I'm actually starting to learn something or not, but I have noticed that when my hands are wet and the line is wet, you know, it sticks to my fingers, and I'm like losing touch and feels like the line is slack,
or feels like the line is tight, but it's not because it's stuck to my fingers. So I'm gonna try that little trick, shaking the shit out of it.
Trying to keep my hand dry.
nice fish.
That might be the biggest one I caught out of this run ever. I got a big brown here earlier in the year, but he's a native. But he wasn't as big as, or as long as that.
This might be something we can work with here. We got, normally, well, there still is, but
this rock here creates a nice section over here. There's going to be something in, but this rock up here where the water is normally only 6 inches to a foot deep, today is probably double that. And I think I'm gonna tickle that a little.
Gotta stay way over here. I'm like crawling up the bank. Side of the bank to stay under these trees. Okay.
This should be fun if this is what we get to do today.
Hey guys, we made it up to the corner pretty effortlessly.
I'm gonna be focusing on this next 100 yards of stream or so.
This corner, everything gets pushed into,
and it seems to be the slowest water around, at least on the bend. But I'm covered in trees.
To take a step out of the trees, take a step upstream, and then Homer Simpson back into the bushes.
God damn it, you know what? I think I got stuck on that damn log the last time I come up here.
Alright guys, this log that's out here slows down the surface water.
With this being another foot deeper, this might be the place today. This is kind of the section you can see between these logs, how the water slows down. This is where I was seeing those big caddis flying around a couple weeks ago. Kind of got me onto this new pattern. Ooh, that was a fish. Nice fish.
God, dude.
Oh my goodness. Look at this. Beautiful native. Holy mackerel. I think I'm regretting putting that back on. Give him some water. I don't want to work my way that way. Drop in here and learn that you have to be ready on this corner. A lot of fish in here. Take your arm off. Because fish are dangerous. Adventures. Okay. Now, I know this is dangerous, but I could lose a fish, but I could also gain a fish. Risk, reward. All right. That is always like 3 feet deep over there. I don't think I can get that from this angle. Oh, jeez. I was like, throwing that in there because I'm getting ready to turn around. Yeah, catch a 16-incher. Huh? Yeah, he was heavy. It's gonna be neat to see here. I get over to this secret spot, if I can get down through this, or if the fish are even holding in that kind of water now. Oh, that might have been a fish. Or a log. Fish. Another nice fish. Holy shnikes.
Come on, dude.
Fast as fuck, boy.
Beauty, eh?
so far away from me. I don't know that I can get there. I was getting attacked by a fly or a bug or something. I think I had a hit. They're working together. Good fish. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Not good. Yeah, not good when you get a fishing trip in a week and a half. Alright. Son of a bitch. I literally have no casting. I don't know what to do. I am the whole way up here, which is easily a mile from my car, where my second rod is. Hey guys, I know if you've seen other videos, you've seen me or heard me say, you know, I caught a fish off camera or, you know, something like that, because the battery will go out and I'll keep fishing. I'm just zoned in. Well, I've been trying to be more aware of that. Well, son of a bitch, didn't just happen again, you know, and I let the fish go. I'm drifting down, beep, beep, beep. Camera dies. Nibble, 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 pull. Oh shit, what do? I let it go. I'm not doing that again. Just so you know.
There's like no flex in my rod now. It's like everything has to be a lob.
Beep, beep, beep. See if he bites. Oh man, that sucks so bad. Oh, I'm getting out of here. Heading back down. And I mess with some smaller pocket water. See if we can't get something that way. Can't cast more than 10 feet. So. That was a half a rod tip. I still catch fish. Our snub nose.